horribly wrong, and we're still not quite sure what the heck happened.
Yeah,
so,
we have no idea.
Yeah, we have no idea, so we're back, and we're going to try this episode again. We do have people monitoring if there's any problems this time.
Yeah, so hopefully we don't run into the issue. It looked like something between Hangouts and YouTube that was causing the problems.
Exactly, exactly. And I had something else to tell them. Oh, the reason Joey's not here. Joey does have a new computer. However, he and I have tried doing Hangouts this week, and it's not been pretty. So we're trying to figure out a solution to get Joey back to the show. You know, I'm sorry, 2 frames per second just wasn't working. It was like, hi, Sean, how are you? It was not good.
Real jittery.
Yeah, real jittery. So Joey will be returning to the show. So we're going to go ahead and go with the topic we had for last week, and that's the fact that fall is coming up, and it looks like we are just going to be inundated with
it's
new
insane.
Devices.
I can rattle off the dates now. I was going through them earlier.
Well, Todd, yeah, we can't give away who all you're seeing, but how many meetings do you have next week for pre-briefings for IFA?
Well, one day is pretty much all day of meetings. I mean, running around New York City. So, and then we also have press conferences, actually, too. Like HTC has one on the 19th. Sprint has one on the 19th. Their Edge event, which I'm still not even sure what to expect from that. It could be, I guess...
They've announced HTC. They're going back to all Edge.
Yeah, right. Well, they were actually never an Edge network because they were CDMA.
That's right. You're correct.
So their 3G was EVDO.
For those that don't know what a pre-brief is, that means we actually go to a meeting and we get to see what's going to be announced. We know the announcement's coming, and this is just a chance for us to see the device early, take our pictures, write up our thoughts, and so on, and then we have to release them at a set embargo time. So, next week is all about IFA pre-briefings. And for those of you that aren't familiar with IFA, it's kind of like the European version of CES, which is over in Berlin. Mm-hmm. And Todd will be in attendance at IFA this year. And it sounds like you're going to have a very busy week.
Yeah, I've been in past years, and sometimes, there's not much. I remember one year it was just when Samsung released their first Galaxy Tab. And then other years, it's insane. So this year looks like an insane year. Like here, I'll rattle off the dates. I have them in front of me. So we have HTC and Sprint on the 19th. That's next week. Then September 3rd is the Galaxy Note 4 event probably. I mean, Samsung pretty much gave it away in the invite, right? It said, like, note the date and had a picture of their S Pen kind of stuff going on. And then Sony's press conference is on the 3rd also. And I don't know what to expect from that, but I'm guessing Xperia Z3. There's been a lot of...
And Z3 Compact, I would say.
Yeah, leaks to that. And it looked like, at least the specs that we've heard about so far, it sounds like it's almost like really similar to the Xperia Z2, just maybe with a new body. Because like Snapdragon 801 and 3 gigs of RAM and the 20.7 megapixel camera, all that stuff. So I don't know what's going on there. And then, actually, I should say, sometime between here and there, I think we might hear something from Motorola too, right? Like, they should have something going on because it's coming to the end of the summer. So expect that. And then, let's see, September 4th, HTC just announced that they're holding a press conference in Berlin. Microsoft also on September 4th. Lenovo also on September 4th. Intel on the 5th. And then I come right back, and the rumors say on the 9th is the iPhone 6 event.
Well, actually, Motorola has announced their event. Remember, it's September 4th up in Chicago?
Right, okay.
Yeah, which Roy will be attending that. That's brilliant. Schedule an event in the United States when everybody is busy.
Right, yeah.
So, it looks like it's going to be a very, very busy time coming up here.
Right, so it's going to be a crazy fall. And a lot to look forward to. I think the Note 4 looks like an awesome device. And all these rumors are saying, like, new sensors and what was the one, the UV sensor on the back? So, like, when to get sunburned or when you might get sunburned or, like, the sun levels outside. That's crazy.
That's nuts to me.
And then today we had the Galaxy Alpha, which was, it is the first metal phone in recent memory that Samsung's launched. And they had promised one was coming, but it still leaves it open. Like, the pictures of the leaked Note 4 kind of look like it had a metal chassis, too. And I hope it does. That would be really nice.
Yeah, so... The thing is, do you think it's smart for all these companies to release all their products in such a small window? I mean, yes, you can say there's brand loyalty. I mean, if somebody's already on iPhone, they're probably going to stay on iPhone.
Right.
So they're going to ignore all this other stuff going on. But if you're an Android user, it almost feels like these companies are cutting each other's throats and their own.
Yeah, it does seem like that. For consumers, hopefully it's a good thing because they got to have, you know, standout features for everything. Note 4 is a good one and a good example of this battle, because especially apparently Samsung's trying to get it out to market like ASAP because of the, you know, rumored iPhone Air with the 5.5-inch screen. And so I think that we're going to see a lot of distinguishing features coming in the fall that, without trying to give away anything that I've already seen, that distinguish, you know, the smartphones from each other, more so than we have in the past, and to give consumers a reason to stick with one product over another. And just a small example of that is sort of the way that, you know, Samsung smartwatches only work with their products, and I'm curious to see how their VR headset, if that's announced with the Note 4 and IFA, if that's only supported by Samsung products with the right APK files, as we saw in some of the leaks. So we'll see.
Well, and we've got that trademark filing now for, what was it called, the Note Edge?
Yeah, right, with apparently the three-sided phone, or three-sided screens.
Note Edge, Edge event.
I think it's too soon, though.
Yeah.
Who knows?
Believe me, I thought of that as I'm sitting here. But
that's really interesting, but I feel like if it's this unique smartphone with three displays, you know, it would be a global event. But I'm not so sure you're right, because what was the Kyocera flip phone? Remember that thing?
Oh.
It was like a clamshell. It was like almost like a 3DS, and yeah, that went right to Sprint.
Also, though, remember the Edge invitation showed diamonds.
Huh.
Which Galaxy. Has many facets.
And Galaxy. Yeah, that's interesting. I don't know. I'm thinking stars.
Well, welcome, folks, to us thinking on the fly. But, no, I don't tend to believe that one.
Looking at the invite again.
Even though I thought of it, simply because the Note 4 is so close to release, and I don't think they're going to do anything else with Note this close up.
Mm-hmm. Take the edge off, it says. Ah, I wonder. It could just be like diamonds are strong and sharp and can't scratch sapphire. I have no idea.
This is the fun. Folks, you should see when the iPhone invitation comes in, and we're all like, well, what does this shadow mean?
Yeah, right.
Which device was it that we were taking screenshots of our screens to measure the distance between apps?
Right. Yeah, I forgot about that.
Yeah, we were sitting here like, so, you know, well, okay, notice that the raindrop here is slightly higher.
Yeah, what does this tell us about the resolution?
Oh, good grief.
So
that was a fun day. But I don't know, it's going to be an interesting fall. It's worrying in a lot of ways. I mean, great, you know, we're going to have a lot to cover, but as a consumer, I wouldn't know what to do right now.
Yeah, what do you buy? But I guess, you know, this is sort of, if you think about it, they're announcing these in September. They might say, I think a lot of these companies might say, available in the next coming months, and then it's sort of on the market, ready for holiday. So this is sort of the holiday buyers.
Yeah.
And they need to have, I think we're due for a refresh in a lot of ways from a lot of these companies. So.
Yeah, it's nuts. So we've got a couple questions coming in here for stuff related to the fall here. And Sachin Bahal asks, what do you think the iPhone 6 will have feature-wise? I think it will make calls. And I think it will have some web browsing and right. apps.
Yeah, I'm curious to see what it has. I mean, feature-wise, I think it'll have everything we, you know, all the rumors have had that we've written 10,000 times. But I think, you know, larger display with 4.7 inches, improved Touch ID. It's apparently going to be, able to recognize your fingerprint quicker. What else have we heard? You know, thinner body. Hopefully more storage, right? I'd love to see like a 128 gig iPhone, but I don't know.
Yeah, you know, and that's the thing, though. You know, okay, fine. So the 5 and the 5S, we're definitely seeing a body change with the 6. But really, what else can Apple or any company do at this point to make their phones that innovative anymore?
Well, I think what we're seeing is sort of the software play. And with Yosemite and iOS 8 and the way that they work together, and you can, you know, go back and forth between your phone and your computer, I think that sort of makes you, you know, stick inside the ecosystem and say, like, well, you know, I'm going to use an iPhone now, too. But speaking of that, I mean, it looks like Google's doing the same thing with Chrome OS and Chromebooks and talking to Android, which will be really exciting to see. I actually can't wait for that.
Quick, for those that may have missed the first few minutes, where is Joey? Joey will be back. Joey's having computer problems. He's not off the show. It's just a matter of technology not being cooperative. Okay, so next up we have from Drake Carey's EV, is Android L coming to the Nexus 4? I believe so,
Not at least not officially yet, but I wouldn't be surprised to see some version of it.
Yeah, it seems, you know, even if the Nexus 6 releases, that's only two generations back, it seems likely that it will get an Android L. But you never know.
Right now, officially, it's just Nexus 5 and Nexus 7.
Yeah, but Nexus 4 seems likely, but we do not know officially.
I'm sure there are guides to get it on there.
Speaking also of new devices in the fall, Sasha Bahal asks, do you think that the Moto 360 will be worth it when it eventually is released, and how much could it go for? Should you and I go over our thoughts so far on Android Wear?
Yeah, I actually put it on. I think the only time I put it on is for this podcast. Just like, okay, I'll wear it. There's nothing good about it.
It is...
I'm waiting. I think there's potential.
I think there's potential for Android Wear, but... first off, we think the Moto 360 is going to cost more than the G Watch or the Gear Live.
Yeah, I'm guessing like $350.
Right, and this is not a condemnation of the 360. This is a whole problem just with Android Wear, and the fact is, Android Wear was not ready for the public.
Yeah,
it just does nothing.
it's delayed in a lot of ways. Like I'll get a Hangout, 10 minutes later. I think I put this on earlier, and I got to hang out from this morning. I was like, what the heck?
Pebble is so much better.
Yeah. I mean, you do get the colored screen, which is cool. Not that you could do anything with it.
Woo!
I'm trying to, there we go, I exit. There's a lot of swiping around.
Yeah, I just...
Don't waste your money on it now.
Yeah.
I mean, maybe they'll get some good apps soon, but, right now, I haven't found any app that would make it worth it. And I heard, I've read reports... Bill, a good friend of ours from Android Central, I guess, was trying to check in to a flight, and I think he was using the Delta app, and it's just not made for your wrist, like a boarding pass. So, yeah. I mean, that was the only thing that kind of seemed cool about it to me at first.
Yeah, I mean, even this last trip I went on out to Irvine, I just used my iPhone for my boarding pass.
That's what I do these days, too.
Yeah, so, nope, sorry, the 360, no.
Unless it's got great battery life and is introduced. I mean, we can't forget that Motorola is still working with Google, right? Like, I think they're still part of Google. The deal hasn't closed with Lenovo. So I think you still have some of that team there that worked on the Moto X and those devices, and that's a fantastic device. And if they take some of that inspiration and the cool stuff that they did there and bring it over to the watch, then maybe there's just unique features to the Moto 360 that make it worth buying. So that's what I would say.
So we've got a couple questions here from, and I'm going to apologize in advance, Shashwat Punjabi. I'm very sorry if I mispronounced your name. What do you guys think about the Samsung Galaxy Alpha? I'm just going to say from a physical look, hey, who put the Samsung logo on my iPhone?
Yes, seriously. That's crazy. I mean, it's cool that Samsung's finally listening to people and using metal in their phones, but it does look like an iPhone to me. Except from the back, but, from the sides and stuff.
Yeah, from also, the sides and...
Low-res screen, right?
Mm-hmm.
720p, I think it was. So not even 1080p, which is crazy. And then no expandable storage, so no micro SD. And I know that manufacturers have said, well, it's hard when we have a body and you can't, add that. Well, HTC sort of proved everybody wrong with the One M8. I mean, it can be done. So maybe it's to keep costs down. I mean, when you have the metal body, it's a little more expensive and you don't want to toss a 1080p screen on there. I don't know. But again, just HTC did it, so...
I will say that, I keep meaning to ask you this, and this is the perfect time because I'm sure I'm not the only one who doesn't know this. So I'm responsible, folks, for writing up the spec pages you see on the product pages. So I'm entering all the sensors. What in the world is a Hall sensor?
I have no idea. Hall sensor?
Samsung has been putting it on every phone now for a year.
Oh, voltage, I guess.
Okay, because everyone needs that.
I don't know. No, I mean, maybe it's just so that the... I have no idea. But maybe so that the power is always...
Well, I'll say this. They loaded this sucker with sensors. I mean...
a hall.
It's swimming in sensors. But, yeah, I just... for as long as we've been following this phone and everyone's like, there's going to be an all-metal phone and all that, it's very mid-range.
So weird.
It's freaky to me to say that a 720p display is mid-range, when a year ago it wasn't. But, when you've got 2K displays coming out and 4K displays and just about everybody's at 1080p, you just, if you're trying to go in a new direction, you don't launch it with a lower tier display.
Right, yeah, what's the point? Especially when you're a company known for your screens.
Yeah, exactly.
That's great. Hall effect, I looked it up. I think it's for having a more accurate compass on the phone.
Gotcha, okay. So, I every time a Samsung phone, I write that up, I'm like, what is this? you know, does it check your hall pass to make sure you're allowed to go to the restroom?
Yeah, right. This is the first time I've ever heard of it, so that's interesting.
Yeah. From Fayez Alam, again, folks, I am sorry if I mispronounce names. Is buying Nexus 7 worth it? Not right now.
Yeah, I'd probably just wait a little bit and see. I mean, there's a lot of rumors about HTC and Google and building this Nexus 8. I'd wait, see what comes out when Nexus... I mean, Google's promised Android L this fall for the final release, and I'm sure they're going to have new products that hit with it. So I'd wait. Even though, I mean, you can be safe in knowing that your Nexus 7 will get it too. But again, if you just wait till the fall, the price will drop on that. You know.
Well, and let's be very clear. We are not in any way saying the Nexus 7 is not a great tablet. It actually is a great tablet.
Yeah, I love the Nexus 7.
But we're so on the cusp of so many tablets coming out. At this point, I would just wait at least until after IFA.
Yeah, just see what, you know, what's coming soon.
Yeah, because there are so many. I'm sure there's a lot of the tablets at IFA that will be going, I'm sorry, what was that mouthful of a name?
Oh, yeah.
That's Todd's my favorite game when he has to, you know, do a video on the A9700-2.
Yeah, FY.
Yeah.
And there's one, but this is the one with the 13-megapixel camera, because the other one, FZ model, is launching in Latin America with an 8-megapixel camera. So don't get them confused.
Was it IFA like 2 years ago? You would run into like four or five tablets from the same company that all had model names like that.
I don't know how many
conversations you and I had about, wait, is this the one? What? Wait, what?
IFA's tough too, because a lot of the spec sheets and stuff and the feature guides are in German.
That's crazy. I mean, they're hosting it in Berlin.
I know, but it's hard for us as U.S. press.
As things fall off the top of my iMac, because I'm...
But you know what? At CES and stuff, they frequently have... Don't they frequently have, like, different language guides?
They do. They do.
Yeah, so...
Yeah, so... Be interesting. Let's see here. We've got a lot of questions. Thank you all, everyone, for sending those in. From Benjamin McDonald, will the Moto G get Android L?
Yeah, I think that's confirmed, right? I think Moto X and Moto G are confirmed.
Yeah, so don't worry there. We've got a couple questions on this, so even though this is gaming and Joey is not here to comment, Joey and I actually were talking about this morning. From Draker's EV, what do you think of the rise of the Tomb Raider being Xbox exclusive? I think it's freaking stupid. Well, first off, it was cleared up this morning that it is a timed exclusive.
Right.
So it is coming to the PlayStation 4, we just don't know when yet. That being said... That was a really stupid announcement yesterday.
Wonder how many people like ran out.
Oh well, you should. If you'd gone over to Crystal Dynamics' blog and looked at the comments, basically plagues were wished upon Crystal Dynamics along with death and everything else.
Wow.
Tomb Raider was a dying franchise up until the reboot. And the fact that the PlayStation 4 is selling so many more consoles right now than the Xbox One, that's not us saying that it's better, that is pure mathematical fact. The fact that the PlayStation 4 is selling more units than the Xbox One right now, it was just not a wise move. You have to wonder how much money Microsoft threw at them to get this.
Mm-hmm.
But that being said, now that we know it's a timed exclusive,
hopefully get something soon.
Yeah, you know, and there's every chance that the PlayStation version will come with something extra because of the extra delay.
That'd be nice.
Yeah.
Worth the wait.
Yeah, exactly. So I wouldn't get too worked up about it, especially since it's timed exclusive at this point.
Mm-hmm.
I can tell. Todd, I'll let you answer this one. From Shashwat Punjabi, is it worth buying a Note 3 right now with the Note 4 being announced at IFA?
Yeah, no, same thing. I'd wait, especially because there's rumors that Samsung's going to try to get it to market really quickly. So it doesn't sound like there's a big waiting period.
Well, and there's also a good chance that the Note 3 will see a massive price reduction as soon as the Note 4 is announced. So if the Note 4 isn't appealing to you and you go, oh, I wish I could have gotten a Note 3, it will stick around for a while and you'll probably see a massive price drop on it.
Mm-hmm. So Note 3 is still a great phone, though. I still love that phone.
Oh, my Oh, heck, my mother's still using a Note 2, and she loves it.
Yeah.
Because IFA's in, what, 3 weeks, 4 weeks?
Yeah, it's creeping up on us. I leave on the 1st, so.
So, yeah, if you can wait, I'd wait. Without question.
Mm-hmm.
From Benjamin McDonald, will Android TV kill PS4 and Xbox One? No way.
Yeah, I don't think so.
Absolutely no way. It's somewhat like comparing apples and oranges. You're talking about a streaming service slash device compared to a gaming console slash streaming service. And it's going to have more power. You know, the consoles are going to have more power. It's, no.
Yeah.
It's just not possible. Here's an interesting question from Tehran Sorensen. Do you feel that there are good wireless HDMI DisplayPort products for home computer users, gamers?
Yeah, me neither.
Yeah, I don't know why. Wireless HDMI to me just sounds problematic.
Yeah, I remember reporting on it years ago when it was like coming to fruition. I don't think I've really played with it since then. I'd love to try it, I suppose.
Yeah, I would love to try it too. My feeling has always been that you're talking about high definition content. I can't imagine there not being some lag.
Yeah, and some loss, yeah.
Yeah, so it's just not been something that any of us have ever tried. You know, yes, believe me, I have spaghetti behind my television like you didn't.
Yeah, how many HDMI ports do you have with the extenders now?
Okay, so my television has four ports. I have two splitters running into two.
I'm looking at my gadgets. I think I have three things plugged in. Four things. That's funny.
Ports. Are you there? Yeah,
yep.
I lost you for a second.
You just had a little lag.
Okay, so as the streaming guy, I've got an Amazon Fire TV hooked up, a Roku hooked up. I've got Xbox One, PlayStation 4, the Wii. So between those two devices, that's another 9 ports. So I have 11 HDMI ports.
That's crazy.
One of my splitters, though, is kind of cool because it has two outputs. So we drilled a hole through the floor of our family room. We have drop ceilings in our basement, and we ran one HDMI cable under the floor up to the television in the kitchen. So now, like, if we're watching something on Roku, it can show on both televisions.
Oh, that's awesome!
Yeah, yeah.
That's pretty cool.
It was a interesting, fun project. You know, wait, I can't find the hole in the ceiling. Yeah, since we have drop ceilings, we were like, oh, why not?
Yeah, right. It makes it easier.
But yeah, it makes it. Oh, and the Apple TV. So yeah, the Apple TV, the Roku, and the Fire TV go through the two splitter. But awesome. Yeah, I've got just a few HDMI ports. So yes, I could understand the appeal of wireless HDMI, but still, I don't know. I'm not sure it really ever caught on.
Mm-hmm.
So
like, and I think the only place I've seen it is in like high end, you know, houses where they have. It's just like a couple feet away from the box, and they hang the TV on the wall as, you know, an effort not to drill a hole. But I've never really seen how it works.
Yeah, I mean,
how well it works, rather.
I definitely could understand if you wanted to hang your television. You know, I can get that.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't know. I still think there has to be some sort of signal loss.
Yeah. We'll have to call one in for review and examine that.
Like I said, I haven't even heard it mentioned. I mean,
in a long time.
Yeah, you mentioned you wrote about it years ago, and I remember writing about it as well, but I can't remember last time I saw anyone even talk about it.
Yeah.
We have a mystery to solve now.
Yeah, let's look into that.
Now we just need a talking dog, and
yeah, right.
We would have gotten away with it, too, if it hadn't been for you meddling kids. from Julian Stevens, when do you think the Moto 360 will be released? I think any time now.
Yeah, it seems like it's coming up.
They're coming for you, Todd.
Oh, you can hear the fleece.
Yep.
That's 29 stories away.
Wow. I didn't realize you lived on the 29th floor.
Yeah, I'm way up here. It's a loud siren.
My dad's father was the captain of a fire department in Phoenix, and he drilled into me, never, ever stay above the 6th floor of a building.
Oh, great, and I live up here.
Yeah, because that is as high as hook and ladders go.
Yeah, I'm doomed.
So even when I stay at hotels, I'm like, first floor.
Yeah, I kind of like that in hotels too, but I don't know.
Yeah, I prefer first floor. Thanks.
You have Manhattan right here.
Yeah, I know. Let's see. Oh, interesting question from Benjamin McDonald. I have a Moto G. I have a lot of scratches on it. I hate cases. What is the best way to fix scratches? I really don't know.
Yeah, I don't know either.
Yeah.
Don't talk to me about scratches. I'm the guy that tried boiling his Call of Duty game and rubbing peanut butter and toothpaste on it. I was trying to get the scratches out of it, and I read, like, every guide online. And by the time I was done, it was just scratched to smithereens.
Oh, I forgot about peanut butter.
Yeah.
Gotta love it. Yeah. Now, unfortunately, Benjamin, that's... The majority of the TechnoBuffalo crew are case people.
Yeah, I actually carry a case, too.
Yeah, all my phones are in case. Well, not all my phones. Because, oddly enough, no one's making a case for the Moto One or for the OnePlus One yet.
Really? Not even on Amazon?
Not that I've seen.
Oh.
I'll have to look some more. But, I mean,
I feel like people on Amazon have cases for phones that don't exist yet. Like the
thing is, there's like 10,000 people that have the OnePlus One.
Right, yeah.
You know, who's going to make a case for that? And no, we're not going to discuss the contest.
Yeah, right.
No. I'm going to apologize in advance again. Dimadhar Thota, I am so sorry. When do you think the Mac Mini will be refreshed?
I don't know. Wasn't there rumors about that happening soon?
Yeah, let me see.
I'm trying to double check that. That's a good question.
Yeah, I'm pulling up. When was the last time the Mac Mini was refreshed?
It was recently mentioned on Apple's website, a mid-2014 model, but it doesn't exist yet. So.
Right. So it's been 659 days since the last refresh. thank you, wow. Mac rumors. And the average is 300. Soon. Yeah, the average is 373 days, so it's way overdue.
Hmm.
But yeah,
I'm interested to see what they do with the next one.
Yeah, there was a mention, though, however, in a recent device guide published by Apple of the mention of a Mac Mini 2014, so I would assume it's coming...
this fall.
Yeah, it was referred to as the mid-2014, so I would say any day now. My guess is it won't be announced at an event, though. It'll just appear on Apple's site.
Unless it has, like, a unique new body. I mean, approaching 700 days seems like they have plenty of time to do something. I don't know.
Yeah. I don't know. I would assume very soon. So, from Siddhant Gautam, is Moto X a good buy? Yes, but I would wait since we're probably seeing the Moto X Plus One soon.
Yeah, that's why the title of this show is Busy Fall, because all these products are getting refreshed. But yeah, Moto X is a great buy. Actually, Joey on our staff still uses one as his daily driver.
Yeah, Joey loves his Moto X, and Joey's not a phone guy.
Right.
Sasha, I know you've been asking this from last week. Hey, Sean, any thoughts on Guardians of the Galaxy? Haven't seen it yet.
Really?
Yeah.
I haven't seen
it. When do I have time to go out to the theater?
Yeah, I don't know.
My prime movie watching time is airplane flights.
Yep, that's the only time I watch movies these days.
Yeah, I know. And believe me, my iPad is loaded to the gills, and the second I sit down in that seat... I'm watching.
Catching up on him.
From Sushwat Punjabi, what do you think about the Amazon Fire Phone?
Well, I honestly haven't had a lot of time with it, but I did play with it before it was released. I was not impressed. And our guys in the office who have it are not impressed either. So.
Yeah, I played with it when I was out in Irvine.
Yeah.
No.
Not even the first try. The problem is, too, like... Okay, the Firefly feature is neat, right? Like, it can scan objects and you can buy them from Amazon. But you can do that in the Android and iOS apps with, it's called Flow. It just doesn't, like, recognize TV shows and music, which Firefly does. But, like, I feel like that was, like, one of the big standout features, right? Aside from the dynamic perspective display, which seems kind of pointless to me. I don't know.
Yeah. And they blew it with the pricing.
Yeah, I really think they should have done, and I think you agreed, and we talked about this on one episode, like a Moto X style sale, $350. I'd have one on my desk.
Yeah, that was pretty much what all of us said. If it had come in at a lower price, most of us would have bought it. And also the fact that they went carrier exclusive, and that's not a slam on AT&T whatsoever.
Right, but limiting.
Yeah, if they'd gone exclusive with Verizon, exclusive with T-Mobile, exclusive with Sprint, any of them, I would have said the same thing. I just think carrier exclusivity was not a bright idea.
Yeah, and I'm saying I'd have it on my desk because I probably would have bought it the day it was announced. I'm not sure I'd buy it now, even at $350.
No, same here. Same here. I mean, you and I both have a bad addiction
to buying gadgets.
Buying gadgets. I'm. Although I will say, probably the biggest regret I've ever had is that blasted G Watch.
Yep.
But
it's so dumb.
What you gonna do?
Yeah.
But hey, I bought a Chromebook yesterday. So.
Yeah. See, that's what I need to get in on, like, Chromebook.
I used one when I was out in Irvine, and I liked it. And for the price of that deal yesterday on Amazon, it was really hard to say no to, especially since it'll work on T-Mobile's free data system.
Right. I kind of want to check out the Tegra K1-powered, was it Acer that they just announced it?
Yeah.
Because that seems like a pretty powerful chip. We saw it in the Shield tablet, and that thing cruises through games. So I'm interested to see. If there's any way that I can edit video on a Chromebook, then I'd probably use one, like, all the time.
Yeah.
Like, well, for trade shows and stuff. I don't know, because the battery
life. Site you sent me to for alternatives to Audacity. Mm-hmm. Listed some alternatives to video editing.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Very interesting.
You may want to, I bookmarked that site.
That's really interesting.
Yeah.
Because I love my MacBook Air, but I don't know, there's something about the Chromebook and the battery life and just the simplicity of it all. You know, it's just the web.
Right,
and that's where we spend 99% of our time. Right?
So, you know, anytime my internet's gone down, I'm like...
Now what?
I mean,
yeah, right.
I guess I could go into Word and edit a document, but
yeah.
What's the point?
Why would I do that? Yeah,
no,
crazy.
From Sasha Bahal, good question with back to school going on. Which would be better for college, the regular 13-inch MacBook Pro or the Retina MacBook Pro? The program requires getting a MacBook Pro. The program is journalism.
I mean, Retina seems pretty sweet. It's expensive, though. It depends what your budget is. You'll be totally fine with the 13-inch MacBook Pro.
Yeah, but if you're not doing video editing or heavy graphics editing, I think you could go away without doing the Retina. Hmm.
I'm curious with journalism why they don't allow a MacBook Air. I mean, when you go to press events, almost all of us have MacBook Airs.
Yeah, that's a good question. Actually, that's an excellent question. Why wouldn't they allow an Air? I think you could live without Retina. I mean, it would be nice, but if you're on a budget, I think you could definitely live without it.
Yeah.
But if you can afford it,
I live without it.
Why not?
Yeah, totally. If you have the budget, I'd totally go Retina. Do we hit some lag here?
Oh. Okay, let's see. What else have we got here? And again, thank you all for all these great questions. It's
loaded.
Loaded, and we appreciate that. Also from Sasha Bahal, and this is an interesting question. Samsung and Barnes & Noble Nook, thoughts?
Interesting. So they have... Oh, yeah, that's another press conference coming up, right?
Yeah, I think so. Good grief, we're going to be busy.
It's interesting. I think for the Nook business, hardware just wasn't working out for them, I think, developing and selling their own. So I think it's a wise business move to go with Samsung to build these tablets. And I think that's what we'll see next, right? Last time it was the... Tab 4 8.0? I'm trying to remember which one they launched together recently. But this one sounds like more of a Barnes & Noble kind of product. We'll see. I mean, right now, Amazon seems to be really killing that market, so they're going to have to do something, again, you know, distinguish themselves from Amazon.
Yeah, and the thing is, the Nooks were nice devices.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it just... Amazon... It was everywhere with
right.
the Kindle. It couldn't survive. So
I wouldn't be surprised to see like Galaxy Tab S used with Barnes & Noble, because when Barnes & Noble sold their Nook HD tablets, they very much focused on the display quality and how nice it was to read magazines and books, and the Galaxy Tab S has that really, really great display, super high quality. So I'm going to guess it's a Galaxy Tab S with some Barnes & Noble branding and special features.
Super interesting question from Benjamin McDonald. I have an Xbox 360, but I only use it for streaming Netflix, etc. Should I buy a...
I think we lost you, Sean. Or I did.
Chromecast and stop.
I don't know if we lost Sean. Anybody? Okay, Sean might be frozen here. He's talking about we're talking about the Xbox 360, but only use it for streaming Netflix, etc. Should I buy a Chromecast and stop paying for Xbox Live Gold? Yeah. If you're using it only for Netflix, I'd go with the Xbox Live Gold. I'd go with the Chromecast, because otherwise you're paying for something you're not really using, right? And for Chromecast, you're spending about $35, and it was just on sale for, I think, $29.99 on Amazon. So look out for the sales. Definitely a good buy there. I'll go through the questions, because it looks like Sean's frozen here. What features do you think the Nexus 6 will have, from Sachin Bahal? I'm really not sure what we're going to see from features. Let's see what Sean's saying. Yeah, his system decided to do a backup right now. I'm not sure what features we'll see with the Nexus 6. It depends who builds it, right? I think if rumors HTC is involved, hopefully we see some metal. And if LG is involved, again, I'd love to see something based on the G3, which I think is a fantastic phone. Let's see, HTC One, M8, and E8 comparison. We actually just ran that on the site, and I guess you're trying to figure out what the differences are. The E8 is sort of the plastic version of the M8, but they did make some changes, so it doesn't have the duo camera, and I believe the boom sound speakers are the same, and the software should be relatively the same. So really it's just plastic first metal body, hopefully at a lower cost. But in terms of the United States, we haven't heard much about that coming here. What features are most important for you for the iPhone 6, from C. Ben Fee? For me, I'd like to see battery life improve drastically, right? Because my current iPhone 5S is just always dying on me almost all of the time. And I think Android's progressed to the point where you see the G3, HTC One M8, Galaxy S5, all of these great power-saving features, and really, really do get me through a full day of use. But the iPhone still, it's dead about like 3 or 4 o'clock, so I'd like to see advancements there. Screen technology has been actually like fine for me on the iPhone 5S. Like I really don't feel like it's pixelated or anything like that, but I'd like to see it advance further with the 4.7-inch display and even the 5.5-inch display, get a little sharper. Quad HD, like I was saying, I love the G3 right now. That would be awesome. I'm not so sure that we'll see it. And then things like mobile payments, I want to see Apple sort of take that off. So far, mobile payments have kind of fluttered. We have ISIS here in the United States, and we have Google Wallet. You can use it in some places, but not others, and it requires NFC. And Apple has been reluctant to include NFC, but I think we'll see some approach to mobile payments from Apple that hopefully actually pushes the industry so we can use our phones as wallets moving forward. But I think I'm going to... wrap this up for us today, because Sean seems to have Time Machine running in the background right now, so he's completely frozen. But thank you, everybody, for joining the show, and we'll see you next week. Bye.